Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Mark Excel from Mr. Excel, episode 1541, Sakai Gradebook Macro. All right, so over the weekend, I got a call from a good friend of mine who said, boy, this sounds like a really easy thing to do in Excel, but I've asked a lot of my coworkers and we can't figure it out. She's a teacher and the school has a gradebook system called Sakai, and Sakai downloads this CSV file that has all the grades, but of course, because it's a CSV file, the final score out here is not a live formula. It's just numbers, right? That's all we can have in a CSV file. And so the question is, how can we make this into a live gradebook so that way we can update scores here and get the grade? And I said, all right, that sounds like an easy question, but it's not. And we're actually going to spend this week in the podcast going through the various formulas that we need to do this. But first, I want to offer you, if you don't want to go through all the formulas, if you just want a solution for it, I have a macro that will solve this problem for Sakai. All right, and this is free. All right, you're going to go out to MrExcel Labs, allonewordcom/gradebook, and download this. You can have it. Have a huge respect for teachers. No reason to charge teachers for this. All right, if your copy of Excel does not allow macros, you can do the little test macros here. It says a macro may not be available in this workbook. There's instructions here on how to get macros enabled, Alt-TMS, and you can choose disable with notification. Click OK. Now, of course, we have to close this file and then reopen it. The good thing is, once you've done this, so now here, macros have been disabled. Now I have the choice to enable the content. All right, here we go. We now have the macro available. By the way, the formulas here are from Bill Haslett. He has a book called Excel for Teachers. I'm a co-author in that book, but I'm stealing from Bill's chapter 6 on the gradebook. If you download the macro, feel free to click through to this, and you know, it's an ebook or a print book. Support Bill for giving us these formulas. So keep this workbook open in the background, open the gradebook, download it from Sakai, and then Control Shift G to add formulas. So I'm going to use Control Tab. Here's my data from Sakai. Notice it is a CSV file right now. Control Shift G. There, and it actually adds in the total points, the possible points, and we'll talk about that on Wednesday, the percentage, and then calculates the letter grade. Now, if your grading scale is not the same as my friend's grading scale, you can edit it here in this orange block. Just make sure that it goes from lowest to highest. And then also down at the bottom, it adds a little frequency distribution. So here we can see there's 14 C's, 5 B's, only 1 A, and so on. So that's, and also it sets the print range, so we can just print this out and post it for your students if you care to do that. All right, so that's the macro way to do it. Tomorrow, we're going to take a look at the formulas for figuring out the number of points possible, which was pretty tricky to do at the top. And then also, Sakai does something interesting. If the person was absent this day, it does not include these assignments in their total. All right, so this person who was absent a few days only has possible of 250. We'll take a look at that formula on Wednesday. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another Netcast.